क्या मैं ऑडिबल ना हूँ? ओके कैन समवन प्लीज कंफर्म।
वॉइस इज स्लो सर।
वॉइस रिक्वायर्स बेटर माइक।
इज इट क्लियर नाउ?
परफेक्ट।
ओके थैंक यू। Okay, so without any further delay, let's start our session. Yeah. So, okay, I want this session to be very interactive. I mean, I don't want the one-way communication to be happening so that you learn more. When we have the two-way communication, when you ask for doubts, so you'll grasp more from this. So by the way, what is Excel? You can unmute yourself and talk. So what is Excel? It's okay, even if you are wrong, no need to worry. You can just tell what you know. Excel is an application, right? Excel is an application just like any other Microsoft application. It's a Microsoft application, it's a software which is developed by Microsoft, correct? So, what do we do with Excel? Prepare. Okay. And
prepare tables.
Tables. Okay.
It can be used for data analysis.
Exactly. Data analysis. And
documentation.
We can use for preparing dashboards and related to presentations.
Yeah, we can prepare dashboards. We can do the presentations based on the changes in the data.
Yeah, and we have so many other things like balance sheets, preparations, and all this.
Correct. So, with the help of Excel, we can actually store the data. We can do the calculations. We can build pivots. We can build charts, graphs, and we can do analysis. And we can showcase that data in the form of whatever we want. Correct. That's the usage of Excel, the main purpose of Excel. So yeah, let me create a patch for you guys. Okay, so this is how we do. Like we do, we Excel is used for storing the data and the calculation and analyzing the data. And coming to the history of Excel, like if you're seeing, there are many softwares prior to Excel, but those are not that popular. You must have not heard of this thing also, because Excel is very user friendly. The prior spreadsheets had some kind of UI, but that was not very user friendly. So Excel, the first name for the Excel was Multiplan, and they renamed, Microsoft has renamed that to Excel. Okay. Coming to the very basics of Excel, like you see, if you see here the terminology of Excel, okay. The cell, this is called the cell. This is called the cell. And cell is nothing but the intersection of a column and a row. Like if you see, if I see that this is a cell, and this is nothing but the intersection of this column, D, C, B, A, E, all these are columns.
I'm sorry, we are not able to see the things. Like, are you pointing it to something or?
One moment. I think I'm sharing a different workbook.
I think, yeah, this is visible actually. Yeah, I can see your pointer there. Yeah.
Great. So, like this is a cell and this is a column. Okay, A, B, C, D, and E, F, G, and all columns. And if you see, these are nothing but the rows, like 14, 15, 13, 16, all these are rows. When I select a cell, cell is nothing but the intersection of column and a row, like D column and 17th row. This is nothing but the intersection of the column and row. That's why the address of this cell is nothing but the D17 here. And the address of this cell is showing up here in the name box, correct? And worksheet or sheet is nothing but the collection of all these cells. And workbook, like that, we can create n number of worksheets. You can keep clicking on this new sheet, okay? And the new sheet will keep getting added. And there is no restriction that these many sheets can be added and these many, nothing more can be added. But that is like sheet, and collection of all these sheets is nothing but a workbook. And that workbook is having a name here. That is called the, even we'll refer to that one as a file. Most of the people refer to that as a spreadsheet. It all means the same, okay? So a file can have n number of sheets, and a sheet will have many cells. Let's see how many cells we have, okay? Yeah, I'm getting the charts. Raghavendra, online, is it audible or you're still facing some issues?
You are very much audible, sir. I think it's an individual setting issue.
Yeah. Raghavendra, check your audio settings. Okay, or else just rejoin, leave and rejoin. It might work. Okay, great. Or else you can change on these settings. Like you have that mic symbol, right? There is a arrow on that mic symbol, and you can select the speaker, which one you require. Sometimes the speakers will be a different device. That's why it is not audible. Please check that settings. So coming to the file types, like we have different, if you see any of your workbooks, it will be having like .xls, .xlsx, .xlsm, .xlsb. These type of extensions you will be having for Excel workbook. Like if you see image files and all, you will be having the .jpg, .png kind of thing, right? Like that, in Excel itself, we will be having different types of extensions. The versions, like Excel has many versions. Like the latest versions will be 2019 or Office 365, or these are the latest versions. And from 97 to 2003, the extension was .xls, okay? And in the latest workbook, the default extensions are like .xlsx. If you try to save, let me show this. If I open any new workbook, so we have a new workbook here, right? If I try to save this, see, it is getting saved with the .xlsx. And there is no restriction that we can even save the same workbook using .xls version. Okay? Yeah. Like that, we have these different extension types. .xlsx, .xlsm, .xlsb. .xls. This, as I said, like the earlier versions were having like 97 to 2003 versions have .xls, and the latest versions has the .xlsx. Okay. Coming to this, in .xls version, you can save the data and the macros also. Okay. What is meant by the macros? Macros are nothing but the a piece of code which you written in the VBA language. That's mainly used for the automation purpose. Like for example, if you are doing a regular task which takes daily 1 hour in Excel itself. Let's say your customer or your other team is sending you one file, and you have to process it and convert it into a proper format. Okay. And you have to submit it to the another system. And it takes 1 hour every day. Okay. You can try automating that, which happens within the fraction of seconds. As soon as you click on the execute button, that old report will get converted into a new report. That can be done using macros. Okay. You will learn the macros after, I mean, once you are done with the this advanced Excel course. Okay. First get perfect with this advanced Excel, and then you can start with this macros. As I said, the .xls can save both data and macros, but the latest versions .xlsx can't save the macros. If you want to save the macros in the latest version, you have to save that file in .xlsm. Okay. You might be getting a doubt. Why the latest version don't have the capability of saving a macros? Microsoft has done that deliberately. Because with the help of macros, you can do anything. Like for example, if you just click on that file, it can open your folder, like local folder. It can collect some information, and it can send to any email ID, and it can go into the send items, and it can even delete that, so that you don't even have the trace of that this information has been shared to someone else. Okay, so if you get any file with the extension .xlsx, without any doubt, you can open that file, because it can't handle the macros. If you are getting .xlsm from unknown resources, so don't open that file until and unless you confirm the reliability of that source, because it can do anything. So that you got the reason, right? But if you get the .xls file from unknown resource, better try opening that after you get the confirmation that it is a reliable source. Okay. And the next version is .xlsb. .xlsb is nothing but the binary version. There is nothing changed. The main usage of this binary version is like the file size is very less when you save that file. Okay. Mainly it is used in the banking purposes, where they store all the historical information of the customers. let's say if a file is having like 10 MB in .xlsx or .xls, .xlsb will save the same file in 2 MB. So you are saving 8 MB file there. Okay? So these days, everything is getting saved in the cloud. And data, I mean, the cloud storage is becoming more costlier. So the banking purposes or the financial institutions, they save this file in .xlsb, where there is no difference when you open the file, only in the storage format there is a difference. When you open .xlsb, it is more or less nothing but the same file which you are having the extension .xlsx. Clear, everyone?
Yes.
Online?
Yes.
Yeah. You please keep confirming me that if there is any doubt or so that.
Sure.
If you have any doubt, we can stop then and there and we can clear it. Okay.
The only thing that one question is like, why deliberately like they wanted to defer like XLX and XLSM? So why Microsoft has done that?
Yeah.
Any specific?
That, they can't store the data. They can't store the macros in .xlsx. If you want to store that, you have to store that in .xlsm.
I mean, what is the thought process? Like XLS is much better, right? Which can store both rather than XLSX. And any specific reason that they have done why they have differentiated XLSX and XLSM in the new versions? There should be some specific reason why they might have done that.
Okay. I think there might be some audio issue, but as I was clearly mentioning that, if you, I mean, you got the point of that macros can do anything, right? That it
yes.
can steal this information from your computer and it can send to any email and it can delete everything. So, if you get the any file from unknown resource .xlsx, okay, you can open it without any doubt that it doesn't have any macros. But if you get the .xls version, you have to think about the resource. You have to think about the source where this file is getting from. So 99% of the files won't have macros. So why do we want to store that in .xlsx?
Okay, understood.
If you want macros to be stored in that file, store that in .xlsm so that the end user will clearly know that, okay, this file is having some macros. Clear?
Yes, much better.
Great. And here, if you see, these are the versions like we have in Excel versions. And in the earlier versions, like 97 to 2003, the number of rows is like 65,536. And later versions, from later 2007 onwards, it is like 10,48,576 rows. If you go to the bottom of the Excel sheet, you see that 10,48,576 rows. Okay. And if you go to the end of the like rightmost of the Excel sheet, you will see this column, XFD column. That's the last column available in Excel, in sheet. Okay? That's why you'll be having 10,48,576 rows and 16,384 columns, which is nothing but the XFD column. Let's do a simple math. I'm doing a simple task, okay? Like I'm filling this Excel with some random data and I'll take, let's say, 1 second to fill a cell. You got it right? So any guess how much time it takes to fill the entire sheet manually? Any guess? Yeah, I said that one cell will take 1 second. Filling one cell will take 1 second. Louder. 10,48,576. That is only rows, right? But we have columns also. Yeah. So we have to multiply 10,48,576 and 16,384. That means those many cells are there. So any guess, like these many hours, these many days. Same time in the thing? I didn't get you. So let's say it takes from 1 hour to fill, or 2 hours to fill, or 1 day to fill. 2 to 3? That is for one cell. I'm asking to complete, to fill the entire sheet. This one. I want to fill the entire sheet. I'm selecting this entire sheet, right? I want to fill till the last row until the last column. That means I have to fill all these cells. 10,48,576 rows and 16,384 columns. Any guesses online? No guesses? Okay. Yeah, you can talk. Is someone talking? Or am I audible?
Yeah, you're audible. Then go ahead with that number. Then we need to multiply it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So just go and give the number, right?
Okay, no one want to guess. It's okay. Let's see. Okay, can I go with the assumption that it will take 1 month to fill the entire sheet? Maybe. Everyone don't want their assumptions to get wrong. That's why no one is giving the correct answer. It's okay. We all learn by mistakes. This is not even a mistake. Who will get to know? This is just an assumption. See, I want to know whether the stock market will go up or down today. No one knows. Everyone is doing their assumption. Some might get right, some might get wrong. There is a probability of getting equal chance of getting right and wrong, but we have to take a calculated risk. There should be some calculated risk there. That is what I am asking you. Okay, so let's do that. I am simply multiplying 10,48,576 into 16,384. That means how much value it is? Let's say some 1700 crores. Okay. Let's calculate. I'm not even going by month, I'm going by year here. Let's say how many days in a year has 365? And how many hours in a day has 24? How many minutes in a hour has 60? How many seconds in a minute has 60? So when I multiply that, it is giving me 3,15,36,000 seconds in a year. So I take this much of seconds to complete one sheet, and 1 year has these many seconds. And when I divide this with the number of seconds in a year, I get number of years. That means 545 years. You might be thinking, my next five generations also will have to, I have to keep on passing the same Excel sheet. That big is Excel sheet. Okay, this is just for fun, but you will get to know how much big is this sheet. Okay, and like that, you can add n number of sheets. This is only talking about one particular sheet. Okay, we don't have any restriction on adding number of sheets here. A workbook can have many worksheets. Okay, great. Okay, by the way, I didn't cover the okay, by the way, in this course, we cover from basic advanced to advanced, I mean, basic to advanced Excel. Like we start with this very basics, like, as I said, like cell, because like for the first 2 days, you'll be having all the basic content. If you are, if you are a fresher and you want to know all these things, this will be useful. But later on that, I mean, I want to get everyone onto the same page. If you know most of the, like a little bit of the concepts about Excel, then it's a kind of refresher. Okay. But after that, we go with the advanced Excel. Like advanced Excel, we have like formulas. Formulas, we start with what is a formula and the basics about the formulas and how to write a formula, how to read a formula, and what is the correct way of writing a formula, what are the arguments in it, and what are the mandatory arguments, and what are the optional arguments. Like most of the people keep getting problem that till now, as soon as they open the formula, they can't continue writing the formula because the references keep getting shifted. And they face, like if you take the VLOOKUP formula, I mean, even till now, most of the like experienced people also couldn't write that formula. If you know the basics, we have one class where you can learn about these formulas, and after that, I can assure you that you can write formula on your own without any hesitation. By looking at the formulas arguments, you can write on your own by going through the arguments, like how many arguments I have to fill, how many values I need to, what kind of values I need to submit to the formula, all those things. Okay, so we discuss many types of formulas here, like logical functions, text functions, statistical formulas, informational formulas, lookup and reference formulas, all these things. And later on, we jump on to the like report designing techniques, like filter options, all this, the spark lines, and then we move to the like data management techniques, like sorting, like data tools, data validations, and then we go to the data viewing techniques. That's nothing but like the workbook views and the page layout views. Then we have this data analysis concept where we teach pivot tables and the charts and graphs, and even we take the some some real-time example of data where we build the dashboard out of it. And I'll teach you in one class how to build a dashboard and how to control the dashboard. And I want to, whenever I control those graphs with the help of the buttons, okay? So that, for example, let's say you have some raw data given to you and your management is asking to build some dashboard out of it, okay? Where they want to discuss about the in and outs of that data. Like, for example, let's say a sales figures of one particular company. Like for the past 4 years, how the sales has been doing in that company, how the orders are getting developed and how much profit we are getting. Are we getting any losses in that? Okay. In which year are we getting losses, or in which particular category are we getting losses? And what is the year-on-year comparison? All that we do with using that dashboard. And after going through the fundamentals, we focus mainly on fundamentals. When you know fundamentals, then you can easily work on your task. I discuss everything every day on this workbook, and I share the same file in the Google Drive so that you all get the access. You can go home and download the file and you can start working on that. And I give many exercises also, like based on the concepts we discussed in the class, I give many exercises so that you have to apply your concepts on those exercises. And so that you'll get command over that particular topic. Okay. I recommend you and I urge you to go through all those exercises. Then only you'll get the maximum out of this course. I can discuss any n number of examples, but when you apply the concepts on your on those exercises, then only, like as I said, like you get most out of these course. Okay. Yeah. By the way, I forgot to introduce myself. I'm Vinod. I have around 10 years of experience. I worked with many companies. I started my career with Cognizant as an analyst. And later on, I worked with many MNCs like JP Morgan and all. And even I have experience of working with startups. I worked as a different roles in my career. I worked as a financial analyst. I worked as a strategic business analyst. I worked as a consultant. Right now I'm working as a consultant in one of the product-based companies in Hyderabad. Okay. And using Excel, day in, day out, I use Excel. My complete work, or I use Excel for my work purpose, and I use Excel for my personal purposes. Personal purposes in the sense, like, I can keep track of everything. And I did many automations where most of the time is getting saved, and to cut down the cost to the companies. Okay. Yeah. So this batch is going to run for 20 days, where every day it is like 1.5 hour from Monday to Friday, like 7 to 8:30 in the morning. And so it's a complete course of 30 hours duration. Okay. I can assure you that within these 30 hours of duration, with all your practice and very much interaction, as I said, it should always be two way. Then only you will learn more. You will get command over this Excel concepts. And you can, even if you get any kind of data, you can easily analyze the data, or you can easily manipulate that data. Manipulation in the sense, like, you can easily clean up that data and you can get insight on that data. Okay. The only thing I need is active participation in the class and active solving in exercises, whatever I give. Okay. Great. So let's move further. This is a very basic thing I am discussing. This is Excel UI I wanted to discuss. I'm getting a chart. Okay. Yeah. So this is the title bar you see here. Yeah. This is the title bar where you have the file name, and this is the quick access toolbar. Okay. This quick access toolbar is nothing but whatever be the feature in Excel, you can add it to the quick access toolbar so that you have easy access to this. Like for example, you are using some 10 features of Excel every day in there. You don't need to go to that particular tab and click on that drop down. You can just click on this, right click and add to quick access toolbar once, and you can access from anywhere. Okay. And this is a ribbon, which is like file, home, insert, page layout. You'll have many similar things grouped together. Okay. And these are all the groups. If you see, this is a clipboard group. If this is font group, this is alignment group. And if you go to the data, you have get and transform data group, sort and filter group, data tools group, like that. And this is a name box. By default, you'll be seeing the address of the cell. And whenever I say address of the cell, when I click on this cell, this is my active cell. Wherever my cursor is there, when I click on that, that is nothing but the active cell. And the name box will show the address of the active cell. Okay. And we can name each and every cell. I can name this cell to Vinod. I can name this cell to some Ram. I can name this particular range to some expenses. Okay. I'll teach you further about this. This is a formula bar where we can write the formulas. Okay. And as I said, these are the columns A, B, C, and these are the rows 1, 2, 3. And A, B, C are nothing but the column labels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are the row labels. Okay. And these are the sheets about Excel, QIT, and all. And this is a status bar where if your macros is getting run, it shows status here. And this is the zoom options available, like zoom in and zoom out for better visibility of the workbook. Okay. Any doubts as of now?
Yes. This is relation. Like once you actually, can you go to the first to the top?
First.
In the title bar, like the quick access toolbar, will that be, once you say that it's a quick access, will it be saved permanently?
Yeah, it stays permanently.
Okay. Okay.
But this is like not the file dependent. This is file independent. This is the application oriented. For example.
Okay.
You have this as your quick access toolbar.
Mm-hmm.
But if you share the file, this is application dependent. Your friend might have different things in their shortcuts.
Understood. Yeah.
For example, if you open your phone on your home screen, you will be having different shortcuts, and I will be having a different shortcut.
Understood. Yeah.
As I said, that this is application dependent.
Okay. But like, for me, it is like it will be there like permanently, like in my thing.
Exactly. Once you configure here, you will be having it permanently.
Perfect.
If you want to remove it, right click on that and remove from the quick access.
Yeah. Okay. Fine.
If you want to add more, I suggest you not to add more than like some
4 or 5.
It will get clumsy. And
yeah.
You can keep removing and adding whatever be the features you need most.
Yeah.
Like for example, I every day use like applying borders. That's why I have apply borders.
Yeah.
Here now, I just click the range and I just.
Just a second. I think I'm hearing background noise. Can anyone please mute? Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Please go ahead.
Yeah. Okay, here in this sheet we have many keyboard shortcuts listed. Excel, when we are working with Excel and when we are working with a keyboard, we don't feel like taking out our hands and working on that. And when we feel comfortable with the keyboard shortcuts, I don't ask you to learn all these shortcuts, but at least the ones which you frequently use. Okay, like Control C, Control V, and Control Alt V, and like there is a shortcut to add a new sheet, which is nothing but the Shift F11. If I press Shift F11, a new sheet got inserted. Okay, like that. If you want to move to the end of the rows, Control Down. It takes you to the control. It takes you to the end of the rows. And if you want to move to the end of the columns in the sense occupied column, I use Control Right. If you want to select this, Control Shift Right and Control Shift Down. Like that, there are many shortcuts available. I discussed over the session, but you also keep referring to this. Okay.
One important thing is like if my keyboard has for a specific tab or a specific key for a function, and then I have functions 1, 2, 3, like how do I use? Do I need to always press the function key and then press F1 or how is that?
You have to do that.
I have to do that. Yeah. Okay.
Or else you change your that settings in the like boot settings.
Okay. Like,
Most of the laptops, they'll be having this problem.
If you
want to use F1, F2, F3 and all, you have to hold that function key.
Yeah.
What you can do is you can change that setting.
Okay. In
setting.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You directly press F2, you don't need to use function.
Yeah, that's what I actually wanted to. Yeah.
You can invert that setting. In most of the Dell laptops, you will find this.
Okay.
You click function escape, then that will invert directly.
Oh, function escape, right?
Yeah.
And then after pressing function escape, then I can directly press F1, F2, F3 like that.
Exactly.
Okay. Fine. Thanks.
But that depends on your laptop laptop model also. But most of the laptops will be having this.
Okay. Sure. Thanks.
Okay. Yeah, let's move further. Okay. Let's say I have a number here, right? I want to multiply. What number I have here? 3. I want to multiply this with 2. What is 3 into 2? I'm getting 5. Is Excel doing wrong? Excel doesn't know the multiplication also. And we are doing a course on Excel. Excel doesn't even know multiplication. And by the way, I didn't give the plus symbol. If you see, that's a star. Star is nothing but multiplication. Okay, you are asking to give in the brackets. 2 in the brackets? Okay. I'm giving 2 in the brackets. But still, I'm getting fine. What might be the reason?
Actually, it's doing summation.
No, it's like if it is summation, it should be plus. I'm giving asterisk symbol, which is nothing but multiplication. I want responses from others too. There are around 15 people in the online and no one is, I mean, only one is responding. I know it's early in the morning, but it's summer. You know, you learn more when you wake up early in the morning.
Is it in decimal, something like that?
Exactly. Excellent. So if you see the 3, this is showing up as 3, but if you see the formula bar, it is 2.5. There comes the difference between the actual value and the display value. Here, the actual value is 2.5, but the display value is 3 because we rounded it off. You can increase the decimal and you can decrease the decimal, right? For example, if I tell you 2.75 and if I want to round it off to 1 decimal, what is that? 1 decimal. 2.8. Correct? If I wanted to round it off to the complete number, 3. That's what it is doing here. But the actual value is 2.5. When I multiply this with 2, okay, it won't multiply with the display value, but it multiplies with the actual value, which is nothing but the 2.5. 2.5 into 2 is nothing but.
I'm sorry, I'm getting a noise. I want everyone to be in mute, please, except the speaker, except the trainer.
I don't know. We are not getting any.
Yeah, we are not getting any noise. It's clear.
Is it clear now?
Yeah, now it is much better because I'm getting like, you know, some issue with the number 1, which is showing more. I don't know who is it.
Okay, maybe. Yeah, if you're, if you don't have any background noise, you can keep your yourself unmute. But if you're having background noise, just answer and then keep yourself muted, so that others won't get disturbance. But I urge everyone to interact actively. Okay. So here you got the difference, right? There is a difference between the actual value and the display value. Okay. Let's say. One of you tell me your employee ID.
I'm sorry, here in this case, the actual value is 2.5, right? In the example previously that you have given?
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
We can change that to any display value. Let's say I can change that to any display value. This is my display value. And this is my display value. 2.5, I can write in 2 and 2.5 also. Clear? I'll tell you, I'll come to that in a while about this, the different kinds of data types and the number groups we have. We discuss it clearly, how to convert all those things. Okay? Yeah. Can someone of you tell me the employee ID? 17, 14, 16. Okay. Let's say I'm giving my phone number 9959495928. Some account number. I want to deposit some 1 lakh rupees into your account number. No one wants. No one knows. This is the era of Google Pay and Phone Pay. Yeah, that's true. Okay, I'm giving my account number. If you want, you can deposit 441-1610-329. Okay. I have very less bank balance, 5,000. And I'm giving my vehicle number like 8558. If you see this, everything is a number, right? Correct? But we are addressing every number in a different way. I'm addressing my employee ID as 17 14 16, and my account number as 44116 10, and I'm addressing my bank balance as 5000, and I am not addressing my employee ID as 171,416. I'm not addressing my vehicle number as 5518, correct? So every number has its own uniqueness. If you look at this employee ID or phone number or account number or vehicle number, those all are the unique numbers, right? There won't be any other number which is having the phone, same phone number. But there are n number of persons might have the same bank balance, correct? When we have all these unique numbers, we address it in a different way. So even though all these are numbers, they have each and everything have a different data type. Clear? So in Excel, we have these kind of data format. Like we have text, we have number, we have date, we have logical output, and we have errors. Okay? By default, if I enter anything, we'll get to know what kind of data type it is. Okay? So let's say I'm entering Bangalore. This is nothing but the text. Look at the alignment of this text. It is aligned towards left. Correct? That is the default alignment. That I'm not talking about the forced alignment. These are the forced alignments. Okay? And if I write some number, it is aligned towards right. If I insert any date, let's say the keyboard shortcut to insert today's date is control semicolon. Like hit enter 3/18/2021, which is nothing but today's date, it is aligned towards right. Correct? And if I write the logical output as true or false, there are only two logical outputs, either true or false. It is aligned towards center. Okay, and if I have any error, let's say I'm dividing 10 by 0. I have division by 0. Like that, we have many errors. We'll get all error types here. In Excel, we get these kind of errors. Null error, division by 0 error, value error, reference error, name error. These are all for different contexts you get. You get any error when there is no value. Not applicable error or not available error. Okay. So, as I said, by looking at the data, by looking at the value, by looking at the cell itself, you'll get to know whether it's a text or a number or a data or a date or it's a logical output or a text. You might be thinking that false, this is also a text, but this is not text. This is a logical output. We can convert that logical output into 0 or 1, but we can't convert this the text into 0 or 1. Okay? Let's see a simple example. I have 10, 20, 30. Okay? I want to add these 10, 20, and 30. What is the sum of 10, 20, and 30? 60, right?
Yeah.
Okay. But I'm getting 0. Excel doesn't know about how to add three numbers again.
No, I think we have defined it in the text format, so that's the reason.
Exactly. If you see, these three are numbers, but stored in the text format. Correct? We just discussed about this text format. That way you get to know that these numbers are stored in text format. Correct? If I select that and make it as convert to number, Now it is giving me the correct value. Clear? Okay. I'll do one thing. Just give me a moment. Okay. So I just wanted to take a quick survey from all of you. Like we have around 15 people online and 5 people here. There are around 20 people. Okay. I want to know how many of your phones has these applications and how frequently you use, how frequently in the sense, like regular usage in the sense, let's say you use it at least once in a day. Okay. I just want to have a quick survey about it. How many of your phones has Hike Messenger installed? No. Anyone from online? If your phone has Hike Messenger, just say yes.
Or No.
Okay. So there are zero installations. And if there are zero installations, there is no regular usage. Correct? What about Viber?
No.
Anyone? Yes?
No, sir.
No. Okay. I'm making this one also as zero. So regular usage is also zero. FB Messenger?
Yes, sir.
I'm taking some, let's say 10. How many of you open it every day? No. One.
No, sir.
5 minutes.
Okay. I'm making 2 as this. Skype?
No, sir.
No.
So most of the people are saying no. I'm taking this one as, let's say, 6. And at least once in a day. Okay, I'm taking it as 4. Okay. How many of your phones doesn't have WhatsApp? So my question is different here. I know how to ask the questions. I don't want myself putting effort in counting how many errors. But that's an easy way to eliminate, right? So I'm taking 20. How many of your phones are dead? So if you have WhatsApp Messenger, you definitely open, I know. Anyone who doesn't open WhatsApp at least once a day?
Use it daily, sir.
Use it daily, yeah, okay. So I'm making it as 20. So what we did here, we just filled in these 2 columns. We didn't do anything in this Excel workbook. If I go to this analysis file, analysis sheet, it is showing all the information in a pictorial way and in the numbers based on the data we have filled here. We just filled in these 10 values. One is installations and regular usage. We didn't do anything in the data. Based on the data, it automatically calculated and it built its own dashboard. I mean, it built its own graphs and everything. This is nothing but the dashboard. This is one of the simple dashboards. where it is saying that WhatsApp is the top application installed, and here is the summary. WhatsApp is the most popular messaging application, and there are WhatsApp usage is around 77% out of all the applications. Okay, and here it is showing the pie chart. Here it is showing how many installations and how many regular usage. If you look at the WhatsApp, there are 20 installations.
Sorry, I'm getting again disturbance.
Here we have like 20 installations and 20 regular usages. And Skype, if you see, there are less usages than installation. And FB, there are less usages. And Viber, we have less usages. Okay. And here you see the top application as either on installation basis or usage basis, it is WhatsApp. Let's say, let's go and alter some data here. I'm making WhatsApp as 20 and some 15 here. The regular usage is 15. And I'm making FB Messenger as 15 and 15. And let's go to the analysis here. It is still showing number of applications. WhatsApp installations as 20. Let's say I'm making it as 16. WhatsApp based on the installation, okay, and making it as 5 and 0. You see, now it got automatically calculated for the FB Messenger. FB Messenger based on the installations, on usage, and everything. The graphs and the numbers, everything is getting changed. So this is a dynamic dashboard. Whenever we are creating any dashboard, as we keep changing the data, the dashboard also will keep changing. That's the usage of dashboard. That's the main purpose of building the dashboard. Okay, we learn how to create this kind of dashboard. We'll build more complex dashboard where we can filter. I mean, right now here, we don't have any options to filter here. But we'll give some more buttons like this. I want to see based on the year, based on the months, we can display the sales figures, all this. Okay? We'll see that in the further classes. And I want to show you one more thing. So like this, you will be having a folder for this, for our batch also. So where I'll be sharing the every day, I'll be sharing the data, whatever be the workbook we are discussing. I'll share the latest workbook in that so that you have access to that particular folder. You can download those workbooks. Whatever I am discussing that, even that I'll share in the your folder. Okay. Just reach out to the front desk, Divya. She'll help you how to access that Google Drive. Okay.
Sorry, I forgot your name.
My name is Vinod.
Vinod. And the friend desk personnel?
Friend desk personnel name is Divya.
Divya.
And I'll give you the friend desk personnel name number. It's Divya or any other person who is available, they'll attend you. 8686 836 999. Note on this number. Yeah, in the chat, Divya also mentioned that you can note on that number. You can reach out to her on getting access to all these files and getting registered. Okay.
Sure. Thanks.
Yeah. Let's see the data here. Okay. We have some information here, which is nothing but the COVID cases. Okay. These COVID cases, this information I have collected from the WHO site. World Health Organization, right? They publish the numbers every day, right? They have it, they have every number, like how many cases till now based on the country-wise and how many cases, new cases, the total deaths as of that particular day. This data was collected on from 20th October 2020, okay? And you have the total deaths figure, new deaths, total recovered, active cases, all this. On how many tests are going on 1 million population and how much population of that particular country, everything. If you see the India population, it's like 138 crores. Okay? If when I have this kind of data and I want to see the data, this is the latest data. Yeah. I want to see that data on this world map. If you see, I have the information like the top 100 countries based on the numbers. Number of cases, I have the top 100 countries. And if you look into this chart, I don't even need to explain or talk about this chart. Correct? Here, even if I don't have this data, you see this? Even if I can't see the data, I can still get some insights from this chart. It is obvious that the highest number of cases will be shown in the brown color, the dark brown color, and the lowest number of cases will be shown in the light orange color. And if you see the top, the dark brown colors, you have that as India, USA, and the countries. And if you just hover on any country, you'll get that. You'll get the country name and how many number of cases is there. Okay, these are the kind of advanced charts we have available. And there are many other charts where we discuss about the data from the PUBG game, how people are logging into the PUBG game, at what different times, at what different hours people are logging into the PUBG game, and over the 24 hours, we'll be splitting that data and we'll see all those kind of charts. By building a chart, I mean, anyone can do, if they know the formulas and if they have some experience on the formulas, anyone can do the data calculations and all. But it's all about coming into the picture after that. You have put in your efforts, like in calculating the data or analyzing the data. But when you show that in a proper representation, then only it has some value. Let's say you have done some complex calculation, you have written some 3-4 lines of formula, and you have some insights on that. But if you can you show that numbers directly to the other team or the management team? No, it doesn't make sense. People understand more or people grasp easily when they get the visualization. Correct? If I show one picture, and if I show some numbers, which one is very easy to grasp? The picture, right? It's obvious. That's the human mentality. That's what we have. Okay? Like that, we have many kinds of chart we'll be discussing and based on the different data available.
A very basic question that I'm going to ask. This is in relation to how do you get that graph? My map. Which is like how you created that, you copy and paste it, the map, and then you define the regions or something. How do you do that?
I'll teach you all about that in a separate class, where I need to teach about how to construct a graph based on some data.
Okay.
There are n number of graphs available. We'll be discussing all those.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, So as I said that, we'll be discussing about the most of the features in Excel and most of the, like in a couple of classes, I'll be starting with the formulas where you will get the basic, I mean, how to start with a formula, how to write a formula. Even if you have some of your colleagues have written some complex formula and you want to understand that formula, you can do that with all the kinds of topics we'll be discussing. Okay. And the
process
start with the basic one, not the formulas, but okay. So most of the times we get this kind of okay. So let's say here you have some numbers, right? I want you to count how many fours are there in that. By the way, you can count the display values. No need to worry about the actual value.
Vinod, hi, Prakash here. So Vinod, when is this batch covers the macros or just this formulas? You said like advanced Excel, right? Training.
This there is a continuation for this batch. Actually, but the first 20 days, I mean 20 working days, or the first 1 month will be on the advanced Excel, and the macros will be the continuation for this. That's a,
the VB, right? So just wanted to know whether this batch covers VB or not.
Yeah, yeah.
So this current batch doesn't cover the VB, right?
The current batch, in fact, for the next 20 classes, there won't be any VB. Mm-hmm. After that, the VBA will get started.
Oh, thank you.
That's a different story.
Sure, thank you.
Okay, once you are very very much good with, okay, see some background noise from this person. Who is this? 1WP3 some code. What's your name? Okay, I'm muting you. If you want to talk, just unmute, because we are getting some background noise on your from your end. If you want to talk, just unmute. Okay, so I was asking, how many fours are there in this? There are four fours. Okay. How many twos are in this? Three. It took much lesser time in identifying twos rather than fours. What's the difference between twos and fours here? Here, even twos also you are calculating manually, right? You are counting it manually. Exactly. Because twos are highlighted in some background color and some color we have, but fours you don't have. That what makes them. Okay, that's the power of the highlighting or the visualization. Okay, so we have many kinds of techniques. Let's say if you want to highlight the duplicate values in this, if you keep on counting, it takes some, here it is like some 20 numbers only, but if I have some 1,000 numbers, you can't count how many duplicate values are there, right? So we have this conditional formatting, which is very useful. So I can go to this conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, and click on these duplicate values and click OK. You see, wherever it is getting repeated, that values got highlighted. If you see, 4 is getting repeated, 3 is getting repeated. So all those are getting highlighted. So these are all the duplicate values. And if you want to correct those values, you have to correct them. Okay.
In order to get them like in straight numbers, do we need to sort it, right? That is the only option available.
Yeah. That's a sorting technique we have. We need to check on that. And we have advanced sorting technique also. It's like I want to sort based on employee ID and then employee name, or I want to sort based on net salary and the employee name.
No, no. My question is like, you know, in order to see like, you know, after for the duplicates that are there, so the ones which are highlighted in the pink color, so we need to sort it. Okay, that's the only option.
Yeah, that's the only option.
Okay.
But be very careful when you're sorting. Okay? Because if you don't use the proper way of sorting, the date, I mean, these records will be altered. I'll teach you how to do all those, the correct way of sorting. Okay? So I have a simple exercise for you for tomorrow's, when you come tomorrow. We have highlighted the duplicate values, right? Okay. I want you to highlight the unique values. Take some data, or in this Excel itself, I am saving this Excel and I'll be uploading this in the Google Drive folder. I want you to highlight the unique values. Okay. So, sure. Any other doubts as of now or in today's class?
I don't think so.
No.
No.
Only one thing that I would like to ask is like, we are going based upon the course brochure that you have provided, right?
Yes.
So we are going on step by step in that same format that we are going to go on. As you have described in the course brochure.
Yeah, it's exactly.
Okay, fine. Thanks.
Any other doubts you have? No.
No, sir.
Can I go in the same pace, or do I need to slow down my pace, or do I need to increase my pace? It's okay. Everyone is comfortable with my pace.
Yeah, this is very fine. But when you are using the function options like F1, F2, and those, you know, when you're selecting the rows, when you're doing the tabs and all that stuff, just please be slow at that point. Not right now, not on today's class, but maybe in future when you're jumping from one column to the other column, because of your usage and because of your dexterity, you might be jumping very fast. So that is the only thing, because I observed some of my friends who are very good in, you know, using of these tabs and keys. And so before I understand anything, they actually jump onto the column from column A to column H directly. So only when you're doing that kind of stuff, please be a slow. Say that, you know, you are going from column A to column H and I'm using this tab. Until we get accustomed to it. That's it.
Okay. Yeah. Got it. I mean, once you are through with the few classes and it will be very easy for you to.
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
Okay. Anyone else? Okay, great. Reach out to Divya on getting the access for the drive. And if you have any doubts, you can ask them. That's for today. Let's meet tomorrow at 7 a.m. sharp.
Sir.
Yes, please.
Start will be Monday, sir.
Sorry?
Monday is start. Yes, sir. Classes.
I'm not getting. Can you repeat that?
He wants you to start the classes from Monday. That's his request.
Okay. No, the batch will continue from tomorrow. If you are not able to attend the class, you can. You'll get the recording of tomorrow's class. You can go through that.
And how about today's recording? We'll be getting.
Will be the limited access.
Okay.
You'll be having for the recording. Mm-hmm. Once you register, you'll get access for that.
Tomorrow at what time will be the class?
The same, 7 to 8:30 in the morning.
The same. And one more request, can you explain slow so that I can catch you. Like,
okay. If you have, do you have any doubts in today's class?
No, right now I don't have, but you know, like you are explaining so fast, so I'm able to catch very little. Any.
Okay, you might. Whenever you feel like.
When you are explaining the graphs and when you are explaining some tables, especially.
Okay, that was for that. That was to show you. Whatever we can do with the help of Excel. But when I explain through the concepts, I'll go slow.
Yeah. So okay. Tomorrow will be the class from
going fast,
beginning.
You can ask me to repeat the concept.
No problem. So tomorrow will be the beginning class. We will start the course from tomorrow.
Demo. Started and we are discussing with the basic concepts. Concepts in the sense, not all the dashboards and all, but as I shown you the display value, all the actual values, all the how to do the conditional formatting. I mean, those are the basic concepts. What is a cell? What is a row? What is a column? And how many cells we have in a sheet? And what is the Excel UI? Everything.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Sir.
Oh.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. If anyone...
Thank you, Vinod. Yeah, it was
thank
good
you,
introduction.
Vinod. Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Thank you.